Hello everyone and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So today we are going to go through all the time frames again on the here on the Bitcoin price and of course also on the DXY as usual. But before we start, remember that if you want to trade also Bitcoin and any kind of asset that you want, you can find all the links to the exchanges that I recommend you down below here in the video description. With my links, you will get some rewards and of course also you support the channel. And if you're interested in my own indicator that you also see during my videos, I have the 24/7 live stream over on Discord. If you're interested in watching my live stream, then head over to Discord. You find the link down below here in the video description and contact me over there. And of course, you're very welcome also to join our completely free trading chat over on Discord. The link is down below here. And now let's start with the 1 hour time frame here on the Bitcoin price, because as you can see, we are still trading in this channel between here the resistance of 10,450 and the support that we have currently at our lows area down here at $9,800. I still think there is a high chance that we could break out here to the upside and test the 11K area again. But on the way there, of course, there is still a high chance that maybe we come down once more or maybe even twice, potentially also to fill the CME gap at 9,500 before we are heading higher. But currently it looks like that we could be gearing up here for a possible move to the upside. Here in the 1 hour, currently we are trading above all the moving averages. The RSI is also above the 50. I got here a sell signal in the 1 hour time frame, but I think if we're gonna have a drop, then watch out here for this $10,200 area. This price level should hold, but since we are trading now during the weekend, and as you know, weekend is always playtime, there is also a high chance that we maybe could see a potential big week to the downside, even down to $9,800. It's not guaranteed, but on the weekend sometimes big moves like this could happen, and then immediately we're gonna have a retracement back to where we closed the CMEs on Friday. And therefore we go now to the CME chart, because here you can see that we closed the CMEs here at 10,350. So wherever we are going during the weekend, most likely we're going to retrace back to this price level, and if not, we're gonna have a new future gap like we also had over here up to $10,600, and of course the big one that is still open down here at 9,600. Now let's switch over into the DXY quickly, because here in the 1 hour time frame, of course, we close also on Friday here at 93.30. So this market is closed till Monday. So we can have a recap where we closed here on Friday during the time frames, but this market is closed right now. So that means that the cryptocurrency space right now is trading at its own and everything is possible, because right now traditional market is closed. So Bitcoin and overall all the cryptocurrency space is trading at its own. And now we can go back to the Bitcoin chart and open up the Bollinger Band, because here you can see that currently we are trading right here in the middle line. So there is still a high chance that maybe we could drop again towards $10,300. But if here we are successfully breaking here this 10,350 level, I think it is very likely that we're going to see a retest of this $10,400. Currently, we still have this 10,400 acting as a resistance. As long as we are not closing 1 hour or 4 hour candles above $10,500, so above the previous support, which now could be acting as a resistance, I think it is very hard to go towards 11K and possibly also build up support above. But watch out for a 1 hour or 4 hour close above 10,500. This could indicate that we will see a fast move to the upside incoming. Also, if you have a look into the stochastic, you can see that we are very oversold currently, and the bounce to the upside is likely to come in the next couple of hours. The problem is only that the MACD and KSD are having here a bearish cross, so this could indicate that we're gonna have a possible move to the downside as well. And as I told you guys, trading during the weekend is always very risky, but if you have a good risk management, then you can of course also trade during the weekend, but be very careful, because we have very often pumps and dumps going on during the weekend. And now let's open up the 4 hour time frame, because also here you can see that Bitcoin is again looking more bullish here in the 4 hour. We are trading successfully above the 20 moving average. The only problem is that currently we are not seeing a healthy big bounce from it. So currently we are more testing this moving average, and the more we test it, the weaker this moving average gets, and therefore we could potentially see another leg to the downside, unless of course we are bouncing now successfully from this moving average and also break here the resistance at $10,500 and potentially go and test here the 200 moving average, which is here at my target of around $11,000. RSI is also right now trading above the 50 level, which is a good sign. My own indicator is showing that we could potentially coming into exhaustion here in this price level, and we could potentially see another leg to the downside. But if we are able to break through here this $10,500, also as you can see my own indicator, we have a lot of room left to the upside till we would get in overbought condition. And now we can open up also the Bollinger Band here in the 4 hour, because here, as you can see, we're trading in the upper area. So in theory, we could also go easily again towards 10,400 and potentially also break it. But currently we have a bearish cross in the stochastic, which could indicate that we're gonna see and test $10,300 level. And if we're gonna have a 4 hour close below $10,300, then watch out here for the bottom at around $10,170. We have also right now the MACD and also the KSD, which are still moving to the upside, so they are still bullish, but they also look quite toppy. And I think if you're not able to push through here $10,400, it is very likely that we're gonna have here a bearish cross and a potential continuation to the downside, at least during the weekend, to test maybe again this $10,000 level. And if you have a look on the DXY here, although we had actually a quite bullish signal here, we are bouncing currently from the 20 moving average, and also the 50 moving average in the 4 hour is currently crossing the 200, which is a golden cross here in the 4 hour time frame, and this could indicate that we're gonna have a potential push to the upside here in the DXY, but of course not yet, maybe in the coming week, since this market is not trading right now. But this is how we closed on Friday. And now let's open up the daily time frame here in the Bitcoin price. So in my opinion, the daily is still looking quite bullish, even though we are trading below the 20 and 50 daily moving average. There is still a high chance that maybe we could come down here to test the 200 daily moving average at $9,100. I think that is still very likely, even though we are very oversold currently. The RSI is trading below the 50. I got a buy signal here, but also here, as you can see, we still have some room left to the downside. So there is still a risk that we could go and see $9,000 again before maybe we're gearing up for a big move to the upside. But currently it looks like that we're gearing up here for a potential test of the 20 or 50 daily moving average. So between $10,800 and $11,200. I think that is very likely. And even though we could go to retest these two moving averages, the RSI is what is very important here, because currently we're still very oversold. And even though we could go up to test these moving averages, we have to see where the RSI is bouncing. Because if we're getting rejected from the 50 level, then this could indicate that we're gonna top out here and potentially continue to trade towards this 200 daily moving average here at $9,100. But this is what we're gonna have to see here in the next couple of days. And if we switch over into the Bollinger Band, here you can see that again we are trading here between the two moving averages here, between $10,300 and $11,000. And as long as we are not having a clear close above $11,000, I think we will see continuation to the downside most likely. And the bottom currently is at $9,600. This is also where our CME gap is lining up in the CME chart. We also have MACD and stochastic still shifted to the downside. So here I'm still waiting for a potential bullish cross in order to open up longs again, because as soon as we're gonna have here a bullish cross in the daily in the MACD and also KSD and the potential close above 11K, I think then we could be also in here for a potential big move towards 12K, maybe even higher. So that would make me again more bullish than bearish. But currently, since we are still struggling here to break through $10,500, I'm still a bit more bearish. But as soon as we could close here a daily candle above 10,500, even better above the middle line here of 11K, and also have here a bullish cross in the MACD and KSD, I think this could lead into a big move to the upside and would make me also way more bullish. And if we go over into the DXY here, you can see that we also closed quite bullish here. We are closing here candles above the 20 daily moving average, and this could indicate that we will see a potential test of the 50 daily moving average here at $94 and maybe even go higher towards the 200 daily moving average, which is at $97. And if we're coming up to these levels in the DXY, we will remain bearish still here in the bigger time frames, but that could indicate that we're gonna see a big crash in the stock market and also of course in the Bitcoin price, and that might be the last opportunity to buy really cheap stocks and Bitcoin. Because if the DXY is going to test a 200 daily moving average and getting rejected here, we will see a big waterfall in the US dollar index, and that would lead into a big bull run in the stock market and also in the Bitcoin price. And now let's have a final look here into the Bitcoin price in the weekly time frame, because here once more we are bouncing from the 20 weekly moving average, which is a very bullish sign. So even if next week we're gonna crash below this moving average, but this week we're gonna close above $10,000, so above the 20 weekly moving average, I think for the bigger picture this will be very bullish. And you should consider to buy every dip and every wick that we're gonna see below this moving average in the next coming weeks if we're having a bigger drop to the downside. The RSI is currently coming to the 50 level, so we are coming to a very critical point where we should see a big bounce to the upside. And if the RSI is getting below the 50 level, then watch out for a major correction, potentially even towards our most bearish targets here at around $7,200, potentially even down to the 200 weekly moving average at $6,660. And if we switch over into the Bollinger Band in the weekly, you can also see that currently we are trading between the two moving averages here, so between $11,000 and $10,000. And as long as we are not having a weekly close below or above these two moving averages, we are going to stay in this area for quite some time. So we have to wait here for a weekly close above or below these two moving averages to say that we are going to see more continuation to the downside, potentially to the bottom of around $8,000, or here to the upside to the top here at around $12,000. The good thing is that currently the stochastic is cooling off here almost to oversold condition. So if we're coming here to oversold, maybe there we're gonna see a big bounce to the upside. The only problem is that the MACD and KSD are looking a bit more bearish. They are still shifted to the upside, but they are looking quite toppy. Here in the MACD, we could potentially see a bearish cross if we are not able to push through again $11,000 and higher. And the same thing is also for the KST. If here we're not gonna see a big move to the upside again, here we could see a potential bearish cross coming up in the next couple of weeks, and that could lead into a major correction to the downside. So I'm watching very closely also here the bigger time frames, even though for the long term everything is still looking very bullish for Bitcoin. So if you just buy and hodl, this is no problem, because the lower we go, the more you can buy. But if you're trading with longs and shorts, then of course it's a different story. Then you have to watch also for these big swings to the downside and to the upside as well. And with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. Please moon up the likes, leave me any kind of comment, and subscribe to the channel. We do daily TA videos, and of course you can also participate on our weekly $10 worth of Bitcoin. So thank you very much for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.